Hello there everybody, welcome to another playthrough here. We have a new game starting up. I'm Paradox Gamer and I'm thinking about making a new campaign and I want to play as Napoleon. And the goal for this playthrough here is to try to be as successful as Napoleon was. That means I need to achieve what he did when he was at the highest level. And that was around 1810 in real life. I have given myself from 1st of January 1805 right up until the end of the game, which is in 1821. And I need to at least take Prussia out and form the Grand Duchy of Warsaw. In this game it will be called the Commonwealth, because that's the name. And then I will have to take out Austria as well. And they will have to at least give up the Italian provinces and the Croatian provinces, as they did in real life. And aside from that, I will need to keep close relations with Spain. And I need to take over the Papal State and the Naples. Also, if possible, I need to dissolve the Empire, the Holy Roman Empire. I don't necessarily have to go to war with Russia, because he never really took any land from them. So when he was at his highest, around 1810, he had no Russian land at that point. So that's about it. I haven't done anything yet, so I'll show you. I have a couple of things to do first here. See, the first thing to do is to get rid of all the leaders. We have right now minus 12 military power because we have so many marshals, generals. So let's sort them out by fire. And then simply get rid of all the bad leaders here. Well, they're not bad leaders, but the worst ones, at least. And I think around 5 leaders should be enough, excluding Napoleon. And the reason for that is that I don't want to use Napoleon as a general, because what usually happens in the EU4 is that if you assign Napoleon is of course also the ruler, and what happens often is when you assign the ruler to an army, he will die. And I do not want to lose Napoleon. He's a 666 leader and his stats are 636, and I need those stats, so he's not gonna get into any conflicts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's get rid of him, and this guy. All right. So that should help us a little bit here. I also want to make the military power on the military national focus. So it's all the way up to 8. This campaign is mostly going to be about military, so I need a lot of points there. I'll also hire a advisor, 3+ if possible. Let's see, we have a land force limit or discipline. I will take the discipline leader. That puts up at 11 points. Okay, so let's move on and see what we can do here. We need to pick a rival. I cannot do that while at war. I start the game at war with England, the Third Coalition War. I'm at war with Great Britain, Hanover, Newfoundland, and English West Indies. So I cannot pick any rivals. Economy-wise, I do not need the colony. Let's get rid of that. And I'm not planning on using my navy at all as well, so get rid of that as well. Trade doesn't really matter. Tech, I want to get to tech 30, because that will give me the Napoleonic square. Alright, ideas. It's all filled out except for the last one, with the innovative ideas. Missions and decisions. I have unticked the national decisions that I do not want. So all I'm gonna do is check the ones I want here. So pass abolition of slavery act, gain 5 prestige, missionary strength -1, technology cost -5, national tax -5, and stability cost +2.5. Let's take that. Found Indian trade company, gain 200 ducats, merchant +1, and global trade power +5. Yes, thank you. Pass the heretic Comburendo Act, national tax +2, and missionary +0.5. Let's take that. Pass Declaration of Indulgence Act, stability cost +5, and tolerance of heretics +1. And pass Act of Uniformity, missionary strength +1. Now, if we look at the missions, we can improve our prestige. We can establish Reverend France in the Spice Islands, or we can get into China. Well, I'm not going to the Spice Islands, nor am I going to China in this game, so we can improve our prestige above 50, which will give us 1 free stability. Very nice mission, thank you. Yep, so we have nothing to do here, or here, or here. But let's take a look at our vassals. We have the Netherlands, Mainz, Italy, and Asturias. And I'm not gonna do anything with them, just gonna keep them as vassals. There's no time to try to integrate them or anything like that. Alright, so what's left is to add some policies. As you can see, we have right now 8 admin points, 5 diplo, and 11 military, so we can afford some policies. I'm gonna go for the +5% discipline in admin. That's the first one. There's also a discipline here in military. So we've got the 2 disciplines. Then I'm gonna siege a lot of territory, so I would like to get the one with siege ability +10%. Let's take that. That was 3. We can have 5 policies in total. So let me just see here. We have monthly war exhaustion is good. Land attrition is very good. Morale of navies doesn't matter. Artillery combat ability. Recover army morale speed. Yeah, so I'm gonna choose between those. Recover army morale speed, artillery combat ability, and land attrition. Land attrition is a no-brainer. Let's take that one. And then either recovery of morale or artillery combat ability. I think I'll take the recovery. No, I'll take the artillery combat ability. There we go. So I have 5 policies enacted. So that leaves us with 7 military and 7 admin points. So that's good. So money-wise, we are making money still. So I would like to have an administrative advisor as well. We can get stability cost or national tax. Probably take national tax. Alright, so now we're not making that much money, but it's fine. Alright, so let's take a look at the country. We have a force limit of 177, so we are basically at the force limit. Naval doesn't really matter. We can build a few buildings. No cause to make. Doesn't matter about the missionary, no harsh treatment, culture doesn't matter as well. Right, so let's go ahead and take a look here. We have several armies. We have three armies here in the south. We have a small army in Paris. Our whole navy is in port. I'm not going to use them. Not at the moment, at least. We have two more armies up here. And then we have two armies up here. This is part of the war with Great Britain. And then we have a single stack over here in India. Whoops. Let's just go ahead and remove him. Then we have some vassals. Italy has a stack of 25. Netherlands have a stack of 6. They have a lot of their troops in the colonies. As far as I remember, they are here. Yep, a stack of 18 here. We also have 15 regiments from Asturias. And then Mainz, I think, was the last one. He has 4 regiments. So that's the situation right now. And we do have the imperialism CB, so we can pretty much declare war on anybody we want. And I want to declare war on Prussia. They should be my first target. The thing is, we have a truce with Austria. So we can go ahead and attack Prussia right away. I have 2 diplomats. I will put one in Spain to improve relations with them. Spain is just going to be my ally for the whole game, hopefully. And I don't want any trouble with them. In real life, Napoleon had a lot of trouble in Spain, and he used a lot of manpower in there. So I'll try to avoid that at all cost. All right, so let's go to war with Prussia. They are allied with Brunswick, a small country right here. And they're part of the empire, as Austria will protect them, but they will not, because they have a truce with us. And with the imperialism CB, the goal will be to take the capital, Brandenburg. Declare the war. All right, so let's assign some leaders. Yeah, whatever, this guy, let's put some leaders over here as well, this guy, and let's take this one as well. There we go. So Napoleon is not assigned. Let's take a look at these armies. They have 16 infantry and 9 artillery. Same goes with this one. Here they have 4 infantry and 19 cavalry. 17 and 6. So let's reorganize these two for a moment here. Let's put... let's put some cavalry over to these guys. So there'll be 416, and these guys will be... Yeah, I will put some infantry the other way. Like this. You go there. These guys will move up here somewhere. So let's go for Rupin. No, let's go through here. Oh, they haven't joined the war yet. Okay, so I need one day to tick. January 2nd. Stuff happens. Russia has claimed the title of Orthodox faith. Brunswick have joined the fight. So let's go smash them up. These guys will go in here. And this guy will move up. this way. Alright, I'm putting it at speed 2 because we don't have a lot of time in this campaign. Everything has to be pretty organized. Let's hit the button. Cardinal is no longer loyal. Yeah, I'd figure that. I'm not loyal to them either. So now this one is 11-9 and this one is 10-16. Let's move these guys up as well. This guy will go to Munster. No, he will go here. And he will go... he will go here and here. Okay, so stack wipe the Brunswick troops. And we will continue east towards Berlin. A military leader has already died. See? That was fast. Let's see, that was of course this guy here. So he's now without a leader. So let's see, these guys will move in. These guys will put fort level 3. Yeah, so I'm gonna put 3 guys up there. And let's move in here. We're waiting for some passage. 26th of January, 3 days. So let's move in there. Yeah, they will not move. Okay, so I'll get a defensive battle. That's pretty good. He will attack me here. Oh, I love these sprites. They look so awesome. Anyway, Prussia will attack me here on 4th of February. I will arrive in Ruppin on the 6th. And then I have to move from Ruppin to Potsdam. That'll be fine. Here, this is a level 2 fort. So let's leave 2 guys behind. And move along. Oh, he stopped moving. Yeah, let's lower the taxes. Well, he did not want to attack me anyway. So I'm gonna attack him instead. That's how it goes. So let's take a look at the battle when we get to it. Here we go. Battle has commenced, and let's see. My discipline is 133%. Wow. French ambition 5. Esprit de corps 5. Full quality 7.5. Weapon quality standards plus 5. The Militia Act plus 5. And Emmanuel de something plus 5%. So the otherwise invincible Prussian army has only 120% discipline. We have a lot more. Morale is also pretty good, 9.1 against the Prussian 7.0. And we got the fight on the nice flat plains here, so I don't really see how we can lose this battle. Okay, so let's see here. Level 3 and level 3. So, put 3 guys up there. Leave 3 guys here. Move here. These guys will go here. and here. Let's just get the outcome of the battle. It's a little bit harder fought than I thought it would be. We can just add some more troops if we want. I think we'll win it anyway. There you go. 6.4 war score. Very nice. Okay, so they are fleeing, probably all the way to Ostprussian. That's where I'll be going also. And then we have two armies with pretty low morale, both of them. Can they move? Yeah, they can. So we are moving out. Okay, that was the first battle, and I'm just gonna chase them down and carpet siege Prussia pretty much. And let's see how fast I can do that, so we can move on with Austria down here. Thank you so much for watching this first episode. I hope you will stick with the rest of this series. Is gonna be a small one, but hopefully action-packed. So hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.